developing a deep and genuine love for yourself. Stop being overly dependent on others. The first thing to say here is that having a dependency on someone else is not a sign of weakness. If you are in a loving relationship, then you will be dependent on your partner for a number of things. This is a healthy situation. What we are talking about here is overdependence. You need to strike the right balance when it comes to dependency. We all need support, validation, and encouragement from others in our life. Often you will grow stronger from these experiences in your life. You have the power to give back and help those that you love grow as well. What you want to avoid at all costs is overdependency. If you are overdependent on others, then it can be very difficult for you to realize your own independence. This can easily spiral out of control to the point where you are obsessing about what another person thinks and feels about you. If you spend all of your time and energy trying to please others, then it is very easy to lose sight of yourself. This can make you feel inadequate and empty, and even make you feel that you are not real. Overdependence can come from a variety of places. Your childhood can have a major influence here. Maybe you had a hard time at school or had issues with your parents. The bottom line is that it doesn't matter where your tendency for overdependency came from, you can stop this by loving yourself more. So here are the steps that you can take to love yourself more and free yourself from overdependence with others. 1. It comes from within. If you are low on self-love and rely too much on others, then realize that the actions that you are taking to strengthen your overdependency all come from within. You hold beliefs that are driving you to perform these actions. The good news is that you can identify these beliefs and change them. So if you are in an overdependent situation, then start noting down how many times you seeking approval from others and what you do and say. Start a journal and write these things down. You need to know what you are up against before you can effectively tackle the problem. 2. Write and use affirmations every day. It is great to receive praise from others, but if you really want to improve your self-love, then you need to pay yourself compliments on a regular basis. This is the best way to develop authentic self-love. It is easy to write affirmations that provide these compliments. When you write them, you can tell yourself that you are a great person who has a lot to offer the world. They are a great way to reinforce the strengths that you have and the goodness within you. You don't need approval from anyone else to write and read your affirmations. Affirmations provide an easy and gentle way to get you firmly on the path of self-love. They will help to improve your self-esteem and develop truly fearless self-love. How you use your affirmations is up to you. Some people like to read them out loud, while others like to say them in their head. The method that you use doesn't matter. Using your affirmations consistently does. So commit to reading your affirmations twice a day. Once when you get up in the morning and again before you retire at night. 3. Take control of negative self-talk. If you are constantly seeking the approval of others, you will have a lot of negative self-talk going on in your head. This can be very destructive, and you need to work on minimizing this as much as you can. You do not want to become a prisoner of your own mind. It is easier than you think to break free from negative self-talk. You need to identify when you are making harmful statements in your head and neutralize these thoughts with positive thoughts. Telling yourself that you are a failure all of the time or not good enough is very destructive. It is the antithesis of self-love. Reading your affirmations twice a day is a great way to start your authentic self-love journey. But if you have a tendency to self-criticize often, then you can easily undo all of the good work that the affirmations can do for you. So the first step to defeating negative self-talk is to spot when you are doing it. An effective way to neutralize a negative thought is to replace it with a positive one. So if you think, "I can't do this," then replace this with, "I can do anything." It is going to take you time and effort to replace your negative thinking with positive thinking, but it is certainly worth it. Once you become a master at doing this, then your life will become a lot more positive as a result. 4. Challenge external expectations. In the days before the internet, people had to cope with social expectations from family and friends, work colleagues, and other people that had influence in their lives. Now we are constantly exposed to different types of expectations through social media as well. Sometimes these social influences can have a positive impact on your life, but a lot of the time the impact is negative. We do not have the right body shape or wear the right clothes or drive the right car. The list of these expectations goes on and on. Reacting to these external expectations is no different to seeking the approval of others and being overly dependent. It is a slippery slope that you want to avoid. The best way to tackle this is to seek approval from yourself rather than an external influence. Decide on what you truly value in life and stick with this. Don't be swayed by anyone or anything else. 5. Be grateful. When you are grateful for what you have in your life, you will shift your thoughts away from negativity. We recommend that you practice gratitude on a daily basis as it will help you to focus on the positive things in your life. By being grateful each day, you will begin to break down the barriers to loving yourself more. If you have never done this before, then you may feel uncomfortable about doing it. There really isn't anything to worry about, and if you follow the steps below, you will find it very easy to do. At the start of each day, write down 3 things that you are grateful for. These can be literally anything, from the fact that you are healthy and have life to the relationships that you have. As you write each of these down, think about how you feel about them. After a few days of doing this, you should notice an increase in your happiness and thankfulness. To really help you with your self-love, it is a good idea to add a positive attribute about yourself each day. For example, you could write, "I am really grateful that I have the courage to overcome problems in my life." Even better, quote a specific problem that you have overcome. 6. Identify your strengths. Focusing on your strengths is a powerful way to improve your self-love and to lessen your reliance on others. You might be thinking right now that you have no strengths, which is why you are in this situation. But this is never the case. If you are someone that is easily influenced by others, then you may find that you have worked to develop skills that really didn't suit you in the past. Perhaps someone with influence in your life encouraged you to learn a foreign language, which was convenient for them. But this was not something that you really wanted to do. Think about the values that you hold. What do you really want out of life? We all have our own unique set of desires. What have you done in the past that is a strength? Do you keep going when others give up? Are you a natural with children? Think about this carefully and write a list of your strengths. We recommend that you use a journal to record your life transformation. So write your strengths down in your journal under the heading, "This is what I am good at," and then create a heading on the next page, "This is what I am going to be good at," which will be the strengths that you want to develop in the future. The strengths that you want to develop are what you want and not anyone else. Forget about others when you write this list. It is all about you. Don't put up any barriers when you are creating this list. Tell yourself that you can do anything and that you can always find a way. 7. Smile. Here is something that is really easy to do. Smiling often is a great step to take in your journey to self-love. Did you know that when you smile, you will change your emotional state immediately? No matter how bad things seem to be, stand up and smile. You will feel so much better for doing this. Smiling creates a chemical reaction in your brain designed to improve your mood. So make it a routine to stand in front of a mirror and smile. This should certainly make you feel good, as your body releases serotonin and dopamine when you smile. Make smiling regularly each day part of your self-love journey. Smiling is not going to fix all of your problems, but it sure is a great place to start. It will give you a lift that you can build upon to help you achieve the things that you want to do throughout the day. 8. Determine your boundaries. If you don't have any boundaries set up, then others will tend to treat you just as they want. On your journey to self-love, you need to set up boundaries with the rules that people need to observe on how to treat you. It is all about creating a healthy relationship with others and with yourself. Your boundaries specify what you will allow in your life and what you won't. There are emotional and physical elements to boundaries, and at the end of the day, your boundaries are there to keep you safe. After you have established your boundaries and communicated them to others, then it is really important that you hold firm with them. If people attempt to violate your boundaries, then you need to let them know in no uncertain terms. As an example of a boundary you could set, imagine that you spend too much time on social media. So you decide on a boundary that will limit the amount of time you spend on social media each day. This is excellent for self-control and self-discipline and will help to improve your self-worth. As you create these healthy boundaries for yourself and stick to them, you will find that your self-love will grow as a result. So take the time out to think about the personal boundaries that you want to set and that you want others to respect. Record these in your journal and make them happen.